Alzheimer's disease affects about 6 million people in the United States alone. So is there anything you can do with dietary supplements that might reduce or improve someone's outcome if they have Alzheimer's disease? Well, there is a new study that came out on this, and it's titled Combined Metabolic Activators Improve Cognitive Function in Alzheimer's Disease Patients. This is not a mouse study. This is a human study, a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled phase 2 trial. You're going to be hearing about this. So here's a summary of the investigation. So the investigation has 47 people. The average age of these individuals are 71. They have been diagnosed with generally mild to moderate Alzheimer's disease. They're given either a placebo or these things called combined metabolic activators for 84 days. So what are these combined metabolic activators? Well, they refer to a cocktail of four different dietary supplements that are said to address Alzheimer's problems from different angles, such as improving mitochondrial functioning and reducing oxidative stress from unchecked free radical damage. So what's going on in this study? So for the first 28 days of the study, they give people one dose of these combined metabolic activators, usually occurred after dinner. And then for the rest of the study, they took two doses of the combined metabolic activators after breakfast and again after dinner. So what do they find in this investigation? Well, there was about a 29% improvement in what's called the ADAS COG score, which is essentially a dementia test. So people taking these combined metabolic activators showed almost a 30% improvement. And what's even more interesting here is that when they drilled down a little further, they found that the combined metabolic activators appeared to work better in those people who had more severe Alzheimer's disease. They did MRI scans of the brains of some of these individuals and found that the thickness of the cerebral cortex also appeared to increase in people taking this cocktail of supplements. The combined metabolic activators also reduced uric acid levels as well as homocysteine levels, which have been linked to both heart attacks and Alzheimer's disease. There were no serious side effects reported by anybody taking the combined metabolic activators, although some people reported dizziness, diarrhea, and nausea, although these were deemed to be not related to taking the dietary supplement cocktail. So by now you're wondering, what the heck are these combined metabolic activators? So from the study itself, here's what they are. They're a combination of four different dietary supplements. They are as follows: 12.35 grams of serine, and that made up 61% of the cocktail, 3.73 grams of L-carnitine tartrate, which made up about 18.65, say 19% of the combination, 2.55 grams of N-acetylcysteine, NAC, that made up 12.75% of the cocktail. And rounding out the bunch is 1,000 milligrams of nicotinamide riboside, which comprised 5% of this supplement cocktail. So when I read the study, a couple things jumped out at me, and here's a summary. Number one, they started with 47 people in this investigation, but nine of them dropped out by the end of the study, and they blamed that on the COVID lockdown. So you can't really blame them too much for that. But essentially, the study ended with only 38 people. Another potential weakness of the study is that the placebo group showed about a 14% significant improvement also after the 84-day study was ended. How did that occur? Was that the placebo effect? Also, when they split these people up into either the combined metabolic activators group or the placebo group, twice as many people were taking the combined metabolic activators. So not really a terrible weakness, but I'm a purist and I normally like equal size groupings, but I'll leave that to your discretion if you think that's significant or not. Another point I'll make, and this is not technically a weakness, but it's one that occurred to me, and that is this study involved four different dietary supplements. Because of this, we don't know which of these supplements were the most effective in the group, and we also don't know which ones were least effective or maybe not even effective at all. In other words, what would happen if they just compared serine, which made up most of this combined metabolic activator combo, to all of them to see would serine by itself have similar effects? The final ingredient in the combined metabolic activator combo is nicotinamide riboside. And if you're not familiar with that, it's a form of niacin or vitamin B3. Nicotinamide riboside is reputed to have a variety of anti-aging effects because it seems to help the mitochondria work better. And it does this by increasing what's called cellular NAD. NAD is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. See my YouTube channel for several reviews of the human research on nicotinamide riboside. But aside from that, nicotinamide riboside is expensive. And that made me wonder, what would happen if you swapped out nicotinamide riboside for regular old niacin to see if the combined metabolic activators would have the same effect? So the results in the study are curious, and I would like to see it followed up with a larger investigation to see if the same results would happen. You tell me, have you tried this combo of supplements? And if so, drop a comment below and let me know.